What now?
We get out of here. And quick. Any ideas?
I know a big old house, hidden in the swamps outside Saint Denis. I'm sure they'll find us eventually, but it should buy us a few days.
A few days is all we need.
There's a spot out by Shady Bell. Lenny and I got into that dispute with the previous occupiers. Place is well hidden.
You and Arthur, ride out to make sure no one else has moved in. Lenny, you go follow those fools out of here. Make sure that they leave. And John, we'll get Jack back, and we'll get going. Rest of you, get packing!
Come on, John. This is crazy.
We'll get packed up, but we need a new spot, Arthur.
We going then?
Follow me. I know the way.
Should be going for Jack.
We will. We have to move everyone first before that bastard Milton comes back with an army. We ain't no use to Jack in jail or at the end of a rope.
I don't even know what to think no more.
Just gotta keep our cool. Be smart about this.
Hey, slow down! You gonna stick with me now?
Anyway, you were saying.
Smart? Are you joking? We made too much noise once again. We drew them right to us. I mean, how many people we killed the past few weeks?
Far too many.
It's Dutch playing his games. Hosea, too. Getting involved with those two families. Master con men working their magic.
They thought there was a lot of gold.
Yeah, they thought there was money. Ain't there always?
Look, Marston, I don't know what to tell you. Things don't always work out. That ain't nothing new.
Jack's gone. We lost Sean, Mac, Davy, Jenny. And for what?
We can't change what's done. We can only move on.
But one day, we need to start learning from our mistakes.
Come on, it ain't all bad. We've had a rocky run. We'll be okay. We'll get through it.
Dutch will fix it. Dutch will come up with a big plan. Right now, every plan gets us into worse trouble. We're getting further from where we're meant to be going.
Now, you can't put all this on Dutch. You're worked up, and rightly so. Just don't get too far in your head with all this. You'll never get out.
It's a goddamn mess. That poor kid. We chose this life. He didn't.
All right. Should be just down this path to the left here.
Anyway, what was you talking about?
I don't know. I think this life chose us.
You, me, Dutch, Hosea. It's been a long time now.
Sure has. Lots changed. That's it up ahead.
Four walls and a roof. We're moving up in the world.
You ain't seen inside it yet.
Come on. Sooner we get this done, the better. You sure this place is empty?
I ain't sure on nothing.
All right. Let's leave the horses here and take a look.
Check the house. You keep watch out here. Any more you? you upstairs. I'm coming for you. You hear me?
We'll find out who put you up to this.
Sorry, boys. This is ours now.
Where are you creeps hiding? Come out where I can shoot you.
I knew you'd come. Soon enough, you are some of the coward. Like you.
How's it looking up there?
I think we're clear.
Good. Come help me with this, will you? Here, give me a hand moving these bodies. Don't want the others walking into this. Follow me. All right, this way. We'll dump the bodies in the swamp over there.
I can deal with the rest of the bodies. You go meet up with the caravan. Guide them in.
We got fine living. Ignore the corpses and the alligators. It's paradise.
I love it. Miss Grimshaw, Mr. Pearson, would you two kindly work your magic? Arthur, take a ride with me.
Sure.
Come on.
George?
Yes?
Could I have a word with you?
Not now. Come on, Arthur. Can you believe that, girl? All I've got going on, and she wants to talk.
Everything okay with you two?
I got far more important things to worry about right now than Molly O'Shea.
So, where are we going?
To take a look at this eighth wonder of the civilized world, Saint-Denis, I keep hearing about. According to the map, the road up this way should lead us right in there.
All right. I guess this day ain't over yet.
Not quite. Good work back there, Arthur. Everything went okay?
A few loose ends, nothing major.
And John?
About what you'd expect. He's taking it hard.
We are going to get that boy back, whatever it takes. I need you to start asking around in the city for Bronte. Subtly, of course. Public places, maybe start with the saloons. Anyone who can put us in contact with him.
Of course. What about the Pinkertons?
I'm fairly sure nobody followed us. We moved out fast. We should be safe for a few days here.
And then?
I think we need to move a little further. Put some ocean between us and all of this. The mess with those two families. Losing Sean. I see things differently now. For a long time, I truly believed a paradise lay somewhere in the West for us. Careful. But I just don't know anymore.
So we're leaving the country now?
Maybe. I'm still thinking about it. Whatever we do, we'll need more money. Colt? Okay, there she is. A real city. The future.
Big cities. They're
always repellent.
Exactly.
I'll find you in there. Go see what you can figure out.
Yes.
Stick 'em up, cowboy.
Yeah, real funny, Dutch.
Oh, I thought so. So, here we are in a strange land of papists and rapists. America's very own Gomorrah.
Yeah, cities all look the same to me. So, how you get on?
I've been asking around about Mr. Bronte. And from what I've heard, this establishment is our best lead, but I haven't had any joy in there so far.
So, I should just give it a shot?
I think so. Just keep it cool.
You know me?
I'll meet you back here anon.
Funny you should say that.
Well, you know how it is. I told them. I say, that's just
excuse
a little mourning for you. America's dirty little French secret.
That's
hello?
Why we love it.
Born and raised. I'm sorry. Please excuse me. I seem to have some very impatient customers. Now, how can I help? You look like a whiskey man.
Sure.
Dollar, please.
For a whiskey?
Oh, that's the real stuff. From Scott.
Okay. Here, have one for yourself.
Well, thank you.
So, mister, can I ask you a question? You ever hear of a fella by the name of Bronte?
Who's asking?
Me. I'm asking.
No, leave it, friend.
What do you mean, leave it?
Look, I don't know what business you in, but leave it, friend. You and your pal that was in here before.
Bronte?
Angelo Bronte?
Mr. Big, Mr. Italian spaghetti-eating long streak of piss big. Yeah, he makes my skin crawl. I'm so swally a cocksucker. You know what I mean, friend?
Where can I find him?
Oh, well, I reckon you can talk to them kids in the alley. They'll know, I guess. Oh, and friend, you'll be careful now. Immigrants, they're not to be trusted.
Come on now, this sulking doesn't become you.
You always have to be right, don't you?
I'm just giving you the correct use of the...
There's kids somewhere in this alley. Where are they?
Well, you don't have to be rude. I think we heard some in that other courtyard up ahead. Now get lost. So are you done with the silent treatment now?
No. Hey, you got a cigarette, mister?
Maybe.
Huh?
I'm looking for a fellow named Angelo Bronte. Italian.
I know him. Everyone knows him.
Where is he?
We'll take you to him. What it'll cost?
I reckon I can pay.
$5.
Where does he live? New York?
I'm an entrepreneur. If you don't want to pay, then I don't want to walk.
Oh, man. That's a bad breath. Here. Come on.
This away. Let's go, mister. You coming, Cleet? Stay close. Easy to get lost around here. Come on, then. You new to the city, mister?
Pretty much.
Don't worry. No one knows it as good as me and Cleet.
Is that right?
Hope you won't need his services, but you got the doctor on the corner there. Nice enough, fella. That's Baird and Schreiber on the right there. Famous bookstore. Not that I'm much of a reader myself. Now over here's a real piece of art. That's the Church of the Holy Blessed Virgin, mister. Modeled on the famous church in Toulouse, which is in France. You been to Toulouse, mister?
No.
We're Catholics here, mister. Ain't Baptist or nothing.
My mama said they used to burn Protestants and all, but,
Bet they don't have nothing so fine where you come from, mister. Look at them fine steeples.
Hey, hey, you little pair of shits!
Get going! He's coming after us!
Stop, shit!
Get lost! Dad, get lost!
mister, I promise.
I'll kill you, thieving bastard.
Don't you have pigs to feed?
Get back here.
You're making a fool of yourself.
This is your last warning, boy.
Little fool.
Hey, watch it.
I'm telling you, a cucumber is definitely a fruit.
Stands for when?
Stands forever. I read it in the newspaper.
Hey, a boy ran through here. I need you to tell me which way he went.
He ran around the corner there.
You ever heard of the word please?
My God, there's some real fine beauties around here.
Now I'm sure you don't
forget the sun. Lazy folk around here, aren't you?
Fun, mister. I like you.
Go away, dummy.
Stop, God damn it!
What's the problem, friend?
Give me my things, boy.
What are you talking about, friend?
I ain't your friend, but that kid is, and he robbed from me. Now give me back my stuff and take me to Angelo Bronte.
Senor Bronte.
The kid was gonna show me before he robbed me. Now, come on.
You new in town, mister?
Come on.
Mr. Bronte's got a lot of friends, mister, but I ain't never seen you.
We ain't friends.
You don't like no one, mister. Mr. Bronte, he's got fine hair. He got a beautiful house, and I am proud to work for him. He got 50 men, mister. Why he gonna care a thing about you?
I just want to speak with him.
I'm sure you do, mister. You and them friends of yours been asking about him all over town. He been mighty disrespected. Bunch of muddy Yankees in town asking questions. Well, you and your friend should pay him a visit, mister. He's got a big house on Flavian Street opposite the park.
Hey, yokel.
Now, get out of here.
Where you been?
Getting robbed?
Who by?
Bunch of children.
I won't inquire anymore.
But I found Mr. Bronte. Seems to be some Italian Mr. Big in town. Everybody knows him, but nobody wants to talk about him. Apparently lives in a big house on Flavian Street opposite the park.
Good work.
So what now?
We go pay him a visit. I'll get John. You meet us there. Whatever it takes, we need to get that boy back.
I cannot decide which I like less, the swamps or the city. Both are full of parasites, reptiles, and slime. We're a long way east of land we know. Far from real open country.
Buenos dias.
Keep out of my business, woman.
Come on, that's not nice. What's your problem?
There you are.
You boys ready?
Of course. What else do you know about this guy?
Not much, just these some slick little greasy-haired Europeans. Clearly got power and money. Now, listen. If we go in there and start shooting up the place, boy's gonna get shot, that I guarantee. Better like this, you're gonna have a lot of protection.
Ain't no one gonna get shot, Arthur, so everyone just relax. We'll charm them. Trust me. This the place?
Must be.
You okay, John? I guess.
Excuse me, sir. We have an appointment to see Mr. Bronte.
Who are you?
You get your boss down here and now so we can talk about this like gentlemen. Run along now, boy.
Was that the special Dutch charm I heard so much about?
Relax.
You looking for a problem?
I got this.
Don't worry, boys. We come in peace.
We just need to straighten a couple of things out with your boss.
Chi sono sti buffoni?
Sono qui per picciotto.
Coi soldi?
Why do you take his son?
Excuse me.
I said, why did you take his son? We ain't got no problems with you, sir. Nor you with us. But if you want to start one, there's gonna be a lot of folks dead in this room before it's done.
So, you walk into my city, stinking of shit and looking like this, and you come into my house before you have a bath and you tell me how to act? You ask me to show compassion. Have I not shown you almost infinite compassion already by simply allowing you to breathe in my presence?
Indeed you have. Now, we are simple country folk. All we have is each other. And you have gone and you have took his son over some dispute with some inbred ex-slavers. It ain't got nothing to do with any one of us.
You had nothing to do with destroying the liquor business!
We was innocent bystanders. And that which we weren't innocent of, well, we most surely were ignorant of.
You twist words, you lie shamelessly. You think you are better than everyone else. Ti adoro. Date da bere sti uomini. Angelo Bronte.
Dutch Vanderland. Arthur Morgan.
Arthur, the pleasure is mine.
John Marston.
All mine, please.
So, can my friend have his son?
Of course, of course. But should I be out of pocket over a misunderstanding? Of course I know, you would not want that, huh?
No.
No, no, no. So how about this? You perform a simple job for me, and you get your son back.
What is it?
A couple of people have taken to grave robbing in this cemetery.
Well, that is a fine place for it, the best.
I love this guy. I love you. See, they've taken not only to desecrating the dead, but they've done so without paying a tribute to the living. Thing is, they see my men. Of course, they run a mile. So maybe you two head off, huh? And you, Mr. van der Linde, you tell me more about my manners. Salute.
Salute.
Oh, Okay, girl.
All right, let's go.
You know where the cemetery is?
I think so. Pretty sure I rode by it earlier. It's real impressive.
You know, you did good holding your tongue in there.
Do you trust one word that comes out of that bastard's mouth? We don't even know where Jack is.
Listen, we found Bronte. We got in there. Dutch is with him now. All things considered, it could have gone a lot worse.
That poor kid. I ain't been a good father to him. I hope he's okay.
He'll be fine. I figure the Braithwaites were going to hold Jack ransom for all the money we cost him. They must have sent him here so we couldn't get to him. But Bronte knows by now there's no Braithwaites left to pay him. Jack ain't much use to him anymore. Let's just get this done. Let Dutch handle the rest.
Careful! I just hope you're right. This way.
Someone's here somewhere. Come on.
Can't believe we're doing this.
I know, but we won't care once we get the boy back.
That bastard better keep his word. What are these sons of bitches?
Home.
I'll try this way.
Damn it! How many you see? Three, four,
five, ten.
Mr. Bronte! Bastards are trying to draw us out.
Empty-handed. Let's have a look where they first shot at us from.
Robbing grave robbers. We've hit the big time.
We can't go back to Bronte with nothing to show for it, Arthur. Like I said, let's look around where they jumped us.
Think there might be something in here. Got it.
Good. Now let's get out of here. Damn, the law's here.
It's lucky I ain't a religious man.
Let's just get back there. Collect our side of the deal.
You all right?
He best not be playing games with us.
He almost certainly is. Let's just see. Keep your head. Act normal.
How's he even gonna know we did what he asked?
I got a feeling most things around here get back to him pretty fast. Like I said, we'll see where we're at once we got Jack.
All right, let's get this done. Come on, Arthur.
Well, you took your time.
Jack,
where's your host?
Like I said, you took your time.
I'm glad to see you.
Let's get going. What a fine man. Hey, friend. Thank Mr. Bronte for everything.
Yeah, I'm fine.
Come on.
You know, Arthur, Mr. Bronte has invited us to a garden party at the mayor's house. And us, just simple country boys.
Let's go! We have a new camp set up, Jack. You're gonna love it. All right, let's get this boy back to his mother.
You sure you're okay, son?
I'm fine. Papa Bronte said you'd come for me.
I'm sorry.
What for?
For that. For taking so long.
I had a fun time. I had my own room with a big bed and a toy box. And lots of books.
Did they do anything to you?
Have you ever had spaghetti?
What? What's that?
It's food. It looks like worms, but it's delicious.
Is that right?
Papa Bronte teach me lots of Italian words.
Don't call him that, please.
You know, cavallo? That means horse. And pantofola? That's a slipper.
A slipper?
They gave me two pairs. One for day and one for night.
Well, I'm just glad you're all right.
Oh, yes. I had the best time. But I can't wait to see Mama. Did she miss me?
She sure did. Like you wouldn't know.
You had a nice night then?
Most enjoyable. Well, the man's an intolerable blowhard, but he stocks a fine bar. How did you fellers get on? Any problems?
A whole heap of them. We about doubled the population of that graveyard.
You know, I thought I heard gunshots, but the gramophone was playing.
Unbelievable.
Each to their strengths, Arthur. I went in there with a gun and left with a party invitation.
So, what'd you say this was? A garden party?
A big gala at the mayor's house. I'm told every rich fool in Lemoyne will be there.
Bronte?
Oh, he'll be there too. Seems to more or less run this city. At least, that's the way he sees it.
Hey, they're back! I think I see Jack!
Abigail! Abigail! We got you, your son, everything!
We got him!
Mama!
He's fine!
I'm fine, Mama. They fed me good. Italian food. Did you ever eat that?
Come here, you silly boy. You got him. You got my son back. Dutch, Arthur, thank you. Thank you. I got my son back!
Jack. How are you, boy?
I'm fine, thanks.
Everything's okay now. Abigail?
Can I go play now?
So?
Well, we met Mr. Bronte. He is quite a character.
Is he now?
You ever meet an Italian strong man before?
Not outside of a circus.
Well, let me tell you all about him. John, you go be with your family. Arthur, thank you. Boys, we got some work to do. Interesting work. But first, let's have a drink. We got Jack back!
Well, the boy's safe, thank goodness.
Everyone thank you, Arthur. I... I don't know how to say it. Thank you.
I understand. Come on. Do as Dutch says. Go be with your family.
Make some room for John there.
Come on, are we celebrating?
Come on! Yes, we're good to have you back, kid. We missed you. Hey, how about a song?
How are you?
Out of the air. Play us away.
La Sierra Morena, cielito lindo, vienen bajando. Un par de ojitos negros, cielito lindo de
trabando.
La Sierra Morena, cielito lindo, vienen bajando. Un par de ojitos negros, cielito lindo de contrabando.
Ay, 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 cantan los colores,
porque cantando se alegran, cielito lindo los corazones. Ese lunar que tiene cielito lindo junto a la boca, no se lo des a nadie, cielito lindo que a mí me toca. Ese lunar que tiene cielito lindo junto a la boca, no se lo des a nadie, cielito lindo que a mí me toca.
Ay, 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 ay.
Mrs. Adler?
Hello, Arthur.
Welcome back, Jack.
Hey, I thought you were going to do some digging in San Denis for Bronte.
Oh, I'm getting right on it. I promise.
Let me get you something.
Thanks, Mama. Can I play a little?
Of course, you can.
Well done, Jack.
Good to get him with that Dutch and Arthur.
The old guy. I'm very relieved. We all are.
Yeah. Thank God it worked.